Thank you, Norman, and thank you for all of you for being here. Thank you for being here with Holly today to fight for Jeffrey. And I would like to thank you all for being here today on behalf of all Reporters Without Borders team who has been defending journalists, journalist sources, and freedom of information all around the world since 1985. As an organization that defends freedom of information, we are extremely concerned by the precedent set in the United States government case against Jeffrey Sterling. Jeffrey Sterling is now in jail for merely talking to a journalist. He was sentenced based only on circumstantial evidence. The evidence that formed the basis of his conviction consisted only on multiple emails and telephone conversation between the two men, between Jeffrey Sterling and James Risen. No content directly prove that Jeffrey Sterling was a source. The content of most of the email and phone conversation remains unknown. Only the metadata have been made public. Here is Reporters Without Borders' main concern. The Department of Justice of the United States built a case against Jeffrey Sterling based entirely on circumstantial evidence and obtained his conviction in what the BBC called a trial by metadata. How is it possible that proving the mere existence of contact between a former CIA operative and a reporter is sufficient to convict someone of espionage? Is a relationship with a reporter the new catalyst for government prosecution of whistleblower, whether alleged or actual? If anybody can be sentenced in the United States just because he was merely talking to a journalist, where is the press freedom going in the country of the First Amendment? Prosecution of whistleblowers have a direct chilling impact on government representatives. We're not even afraid to just talk to a journalist or to appear in an email exchange or to talk just about basic information, not even confidential information. The Obama administration has prosecuted a total of 8 whistleblowers under the Espionage Act, which is more than any previous administration combined. President Barack Obama's war on whistleblower played an important role in the decline of the United States in Reporters Without Borders Press Freedom Index. The United States now ranks at the 49th position out of 180 countries, a 14 places drop since 2012. Reporters Without Borders stands with Jeffrey Sterling and supports him in his effort to appeal his conviction. We stand with Holly, but we stand with 150,000 people who signed Holly's petition on change.org and on Roots Action to request a presidential pardon. I would like to thank these 150,000 people who are standing for a free press, who are standing for better protection of journalist sources, but who are standing for Jeffrey. Thank you to them.